Most kids grow up with Lego, and one man never quite grew out of playing with plastic bricks. Ryan McNaught became a Lego certified professional. Yes, there is such a thing, and he's now showing off his incredible creations at an exhibition in Melbourne. Libby Gorr is checking it out for us this morning. Morning, Libby.
Morning, studio. Well, the first thing you have to know about what's going on in Melbourne, Victoria, is that it's school holidays, right? So this is why this is such a little clever exhibition that cashes in completely on that. Ryan McKnaught is the name of the man. Now, his Lego name is actually Brickman. And anyone can have a Lego name. What you do is you take your favourite component of Lego and you team it up with how it makes you feel as a person. So Ryan, his favourite bit of Lego is brick and it makes him feel like a man. My Lego name is Instruction Psychopath, because I still haven't quite got the hang of it. However, I will take you around this Lego exhibition this morning. It's coming to Sydney in June, but for the rest of Australia, let me take you on a little experience. Because, for instance, over here at Crown, there are pots and pots of Lego to play with. Ryan's built the most amazing things, and I even had a little bit of a lie down on that table to cover myself in Lego for the full experience. And a lady asked me to get off the table, and I thought, what a fabulous way to start the day, being called fat. However, across the day, let me show you all the gorgeous things that Ryan has built, and I will introduce you to the brick man himself, Ryan McKnaught, the only certified Lego builder in the Southern Hemisphere. Back to you, Sarah.
Well, Libby Gorr joins us live again from Melbourne with a very special guest from the Lego exhibition.
You.
Libby, is it true this guest goes by the name of the Brickman?
It is. It is. This is the Brickman, Ryan McKnaught. Would you make him welcome to Studio 10? Now, Ryan is responsible for all sorts of amazing creations. For instance, Ryan, tell us about this.
This is the Lego Love Boat. This is a quarter of a million Lego bricks and took me over 6 months to put together. And like all good 80s retro things, it's got every guest star that was ever on board.
Oh, well, that just sounds completely bizarre. And is your marriage still intact after that exercise?
Absolutely. I'm very lucky to have a good wife.
Well, you are incredibly lucky. Where do you start with something like that?
Like any good thing, it's about research. So I had to watch lots of tacky 80s episodes of the Love Boat. So, yeah, lots of Captain Stubing.
Yeah, but I just want to know, if you start with that, which is like one brick.
You bet. Right, just like that one. Right, exactly that one.
And do you use instructions?
Absolutely not. That's cheating.
So you make up the instructions?
Yep, that's right. So we sit down and do a lot of sketches, drawings, all of that kind of stuff first and go from there.
How does a man like you get this job to be the only certified Lego professional in the Southern Hemisphere? He was quite normal before he got into this.
Very lucky, right place at the right time. I used to be in IT all those years ago, and I wrote a piece of software that some guys from Lego saw, and they said, come in and do some work for us.
So, you know, Lego's been going for like 83 years altogether, and it's had a bit of a resurgence of late, as you will know if you have empty pockets like me. You will be getting hucked to buy Lego things to make things like this. What's this one, Ryan?
So we've got over here, we've got one of the roulettes from the RAAF, which is cool. This is actually designed to be hung from a toy store in formation. So there's six of the roulettes flying around. So some of them are upside down and all of the rest.
So that would be your job then, to make things for the toy stores?
Yeah, that's predominantly what I do.
So right.
This one here though, this one's a bit of a personal project of mine. This is the Ferrari from the movie Ferris Bueller's Day Off. And I could never afford the real Ferrari, so I had to build my own.
How long did that take?
That took about 6 weeks to put together.
And do you let the kids in to help, or do you lock yourself in a room?
No, the kids, it's all about the kids. So, yeah, the kids are involved. Sometimes they end up a little bit different, but that's okay.
What about this? Now, this is something I reckon Stephen K. Amos will adore this.
So, we've got a bit of a take on Jetstar. Instead of Jetstar, we've got Star Wars, or the Death Star instead of Jetstar. And so all the characters from Star Wars are on board having a great time going on a holiday to the Gold Coast.
Quite extraordinary. So,
I've got to say, I absolutely love that.
And as I said, the figurines, there are 5 billion Lego figurines that have been made by Lego over since 2075 when they started making
75,
figurines.
75, that's right, spot on.
So that is the largest population of people in the world, the Lego figurine. Can you imagine?
They're going to wake up one day too.
So what we'll do is we'll come back to you, panel, and perhaps you can throw some suggestions to us so that Ryan can actually build you something. You reckon you can build anything?
Absolutely. Yeah, hand over the bricks.
I've got a request, please.
It all starts with a brick. Back to you.
I've got a request. We were talking earlier about finding love as a single person. Could you make me a life-size Lego person?
Well, you know, funny you should say that, but I don't necessarily know whether the life-size Lego person will have... Well, if you were writing a list, I actually think that the Lego person would just be perfect because, quite frankly, how can you choose your love from a list? Yeah. Doesn't it just hit you splat in the face and then you think, what happened?
Yeah. Well, look, we'll leave the challenge there for you, Libby. Hopefully you can deliver. And an interesting point about that, that the Lego Jetstar plane, it actually has more leg room than the real thing. Well, Lego bricks play a cherished role in childhoods across the globe. Libby Gorr joins us live from Brickvention in Melbourne. Is that what we're calling it now, Libby?
Hello, everyone.
What have you created? How's that life-size man coming along for Stephen?
Well, actually, Sarah, I was hoping to bring you that, but unfortunately I seem to have lost control of the crew. So Blade, who does all the communications that gets me to air, is busy. Blade, what have you made?
Made my name.
He's made his name. Isn't that sweet? And look, this is Cam. He's in charge of the camera.
Hi, guys.
And what have you made, Cam?
A temple, a Chinese temple.
He's made a little Chinese temple, and I would really love it, Cam, if you could pick the camera up so I can go over there and talk to Ryan, which would be very helpful. You see, I've got authority. I can get the crew to do what I need to happen. This is Ryan McNaught, the Brickman. The Brickman experience is here at Crown. It's school holidays. You should bring the children. But this is what's extraordinary. You know, Lego is 83 years old, 50 years it's been in Australia, and it's gone through this amazing resurgence. And it all started with pirates, did it not, Ryan?
Correct. Pirates were the first Lego minifigs to have expressions on their faces. So not just smiles, they had a patch, they had a bit of stubble happening, all sorts of pirate things, and from there it exploded.
So take a look. Did you just go and look at that pirate ship without asking me, Kat? Did you? But come back and have a proper look over here.
There you go. So you'll see with this pirate ship, and all the awesome kids having a good look, of course. So here on the pirate ship, which has only ever been shown once before at the expo, so it's quite nice to see it out for real. You can see all of the Lego pirates having a great time. There's plenty of good pirate action, of course, as you do, lots of floggings and swamping of the poop deck and all of those kind of piratey things. So, yeah, it's all having a good time.
Okay, so if the pirate ship isn't up your alley, let me just show you some of the other things that you can make. You know, Stephen, I was going to ask whether Ryan could make you a Lego person, and then I thought, you know, just stick to the inflatables. So let's come over here. What have we got here?
So we have Nemo here. So Nemo's got a great story behind it. So up in Cairns a few years ago, we had thousands of children build a giant Lego Great Barrier Reef, and Nemo's the little fish that's left behind from it, which is pretty cool. And we've got any good neighbourhood needs a cat, of course. So this is Mr. Meowgi, the Lego cat down here. Doesn't eat a lot, so that's quite good too.
So tell me, do you actually glue these together?
It really depends on what the model is and where it's going. If it's going to a toy store or into an expo like this, sometimes we will glue the models together.
All right, come and have a look at this. The AFL football season kicks off this weekend. Oh, actually, Thursday night. There is a Premiership Cup. Who do you barrack for, Ryan?
Of course, the Bulldogs.
Oh, the Western Bulldogs. All right, we're going to have to close ourselves up. Have you got any suggestions that you'd like Ryan to make? Because he's pretty much of a whiz-bang. He reckons he can make anything. Throw me some suggestions. Just come on, throw them at me.
A unicorn.
A unicorn. What else?
Studio 10 logo?
Libby, I'm still waiting for a life-size man. Come on. Don't fob me off with rubber and latex. That's not going to work.
Stephen, the problem is, if he builds you a life-size man, it might be a bit pointy, you know? It could hurt.
That's the whole point.
Just leave it with me. Leave it with me. This is morning television. We'll make you something gorgeous, all right? We'll be back in just a moment.
All right. What do they say? How do you know if it's pirate Lego? You step on it and you go, argh. Hey? How do you clean it up for the kids? Good morning. We've been checking out amazing Lego creations with Libby Gorr. Libby, what are you going to wrap it all up with?
Well, Sarah, I was just thinking, you know, hasn't the show gone so quickly?
Yes.
And we started off today talking about how do you find true love? And then here I am down at the Brickman experience at Crown, where it's school holidays, there are kids everywhere. And then I've got Stephen K. Amos begging me to find him a boyfriend. And you know what? I have. Look, excuse me, children. Oh. Look, here he is. And I have heard that he's not just a real brick, he's really many bricks.
Wow, wow.
Over here, and I've heard he's Ryan. Awesome. He is awesome. Everything is awesome here, Joe. Yep. But look, Ryan is the centre of attention. You can see that we've got a huge crowd. I'm actually having a weatherman moment. Look, everybody wants to wave at the camera.
Oh, great.
And Ryan has made me this.
Oh.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you to all of you at Studio 10 for coming to the Brickman experience here at Crown. Ryan is the guru behind it all, and Lego has had this complete resurgence. It's a family-owned company, four generations, yeah?
Still hasn't changed. The same family still owns it.
Amazing. And look at these people. It's like the place hasn't even opened yet, and they've come streaming in. Wow. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you very much for all of your work this morning, Libby. We'll put all the details on the Brickman experience on the screen, but on our Facebook page. There you go. We'll put that on our Facebook page as well. And Jono, that Lego man has the same hair as you.
Yes, we're soul buddies. But I tell you what, he's more my style, that kind of, that Lego man, strong chin, that kind of thing.